introducing the new channel that will change your life forever. No, that's too much. In now, introducing the new channel that will change the fate of the world forever. That is definitely not how you do a YouTube intro. Hey guys, everyone, welcome back to yet another video on this channel. We want to help you make your video look good, look better, and all that stuff. But we also want to give you some free tips, some free tools, some free hacks that hopefully will help you or bring value to your content creation process. So if you guys want to be a part of this community, consider subscribing today. If you are subscribed already, thank you for supporting this channel. It's very much appreciated. Okay, so how do you make a basic, simple YouTube intro in Final Cut Pro? We're gonna do that today in two parts. In the first part, I'm gonna show you guys some basic principle, animation principle in Final Cut Pro. And in the second part, we'll be using this free preset that I created. You can find the link in the description. You can download it and we'll go through the parameters. We'll try to give some examples. So I know some of you guys would like to go immediately to the second part. You can do that or you can just watch the video. It doesn't matter to me. I just really wanna help give value and give back to the content creators out there. All right, let's get it. Okay, so first of all, we want to create a new project, and to do that, you go to Final Cut Pro, File, New, Project, or Command N. So you can just name your project the way you want it. Let's say Intro or Reveal. I wouldn't change anything for now. I would use HD. The reason why I'm going to use an HD timeline is because it's going to be faster to edit and we're not going to lose a lot of quality even if we upscale it later to 4K. So I'm using the HD timeline for efficiency. So 920, everything's correct, so I'm gonna put okay. Okay, so now let's create a custom background. And to do that, we need to go to the title and generator sidebar, and then generator, and then custom. Press W to import the generator onto the sidebar. All right, let's animate this background a little bit. Let's go to the inspector bar and see what we can do. So as you can see here, we can change the color. And these are my preset colors that I usually use for my brand. But of course, you can choose whatever color you want. Just remember to use complementary colors because choosing the right color palettes is very important when you design. Okay, just a random quick break right here. Let me know in the comment section, what's the primary color of your brand? Or what color would you consider becoming the primary color of your brand when you have one?
You know, most editing software use this linear horizontal timeline, and so if we place a keyframe somewhere here and then go back to the beginning of the background, move it out of the frame on the right side, it will gradually come into the frame from that side. And really that's what keyframes do. They animate the clip or the tool from one set parameter to another. Now press and hold Alt Option, then click and drag to create a duplicate of the background. This duplicate will have the exact animation that the first one had. Let's put a couple of frames away from the beginning of the timeline and change the color to a brighter color. And let's see what we get. All right, looks nice, that's nice. I like it. Adjust and move around the second duplicate to your liking, and when you're satisfied with the animation, create a new compound clip so that we can have one clip. Okay, select all, Command A, and then right click, create a new compound clip. Now we have our main background animated. And now we can add some titles. For this one, we wanna go to the title, custom. And this custom title tool right here in Final Cut Pro, this preset right here is really, really cool because you have so many parameters published right here on the inspector. But first, let's change the color of the text so that we can see it. Go to the text inspector, scroll down to face, and then color. There you go. So here's the cool thing about this preset right here. You can add an in animation and an out animation as well. And it's already there for you. You just have to change the parameters here. So let's move a little bit further on the timeline and change the X position. So in this case, we're trying to animate the beginning or the end position of this text. We can also change the tracking, which is the distance between the letters. And so this is how it looks like. Now, to have a better perspective of the composition of this animation, go to 50% view and then go to view and then show horizon. You know what? I want to create a mask to make this animation appear only from the middle of the screen. Okay, let's go to effect, mask, and we're going to use the draw mask tool. Drag and drop into your text and make sure you are in the video inspector tab. And then start in the middle to draw the mask. If your text animation doesn't appear, don't worry, you just need to invert the mask. There you go. Look at that. And you can edit the title at any time, write what you want to write, and even adjust the position and make sure the composition is something that you like. Now, if we duplicate this and just do the opposite of everything we just did, we will have a pretty decent animation. Because it's a duplicate, you will still have the mask, but now you have to do the opposite of what you did before. Now, keep in mind, guys, that Final Cut Pro is not a software dedicated for animation. But you know what? I'm okay with what we accomplished. I'm okay with this. It looks pretty decent. And then to finish, let's create a compound clip. And this will be our animated text. We can also select a background with this new compound clip and then create a new one so that we can have only one clip for the background and the text. There you go. So go ahead and experiment changing the parameters using keyframes. That's how you animate the text and the background. And then at the end in one of my videos, if you guys remember, you just put them in a compound clip. And then you'll be able to use and reuse it again later on in other projects. But now let's see the preset that I put in the description and see what we can do with that. Now in this video, we're not going to talk about how to install the preset. I have another video going to the detail of how to install presets. So go ahead and check that out and come back to this video. I'll be waiting. So now that you downloaded and installed the preset, let's go to the text sidebar and type Neat, and there is the Neat opener. A quick preview. Drag and drop or press Q if you want it to be on top of the footage on the timeline. Now, before you say, but that's not my logo. I got you. In the inspector tab on the right, I published as many parameters as possible for you to have complete control on what you want, but also on what you don't want. Let's first start with the mode. This mode parameter here will help you choose if you want to use the logo version of the animation or the title version. Then we have the drop zone where you can literally put any picture, video, or logo you want. Let's say you want to use the YouTube logo. By the way, this logo is included inside the preset folder you downloaded. You can change the size, the position, the opacity. Actually, you can do the same thing with all the other elements in this preset. You can change their colors. If you don't like them, you can make them invisible by changing their opacity and so on. And when you are on the title mode, the logo will be invisible automatically. And you can use the preset as a title animation. So really, you can do whatever you want. And this is a quick animation I created, and it's for free. So hey. Another idea would be to use it as a simple title animation. You can just get rid of the backgrounds and then start moving it around and change the colors and fonts and all that stuff. And you will have a nice, simple title, but neat animation. Feel free to use it, guys. You can even share it if you want to. That's all I have for this video, guys, and if you got some value from this one, press that like button, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and push that notification bell, especially if you want more content like this one. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.